Hi everyone, and welcome back to Within a Budget. Or if you're new here, welcome. I hope the new year's been treating you really kind so far. Today I'm going to share with you a grocery haul, but I'm going to do it a little bit different. For the month of January, I have decided that I am going to do a pantry challenge at home and just allow myself £25 per week for shopping to pick up the fresh things, milk, bread, yogurts, things that the kids actually need because they're not so keen on doing this type of thing probably. But obviously I have a lot of things in my cupboard. I have the packets of sauces that I'm not very good at rotating through. The jars I'm normally okay with and the tins I'm normally okay with. I'm pretty sure that I've got jellies in my cupboard that are probably out of date and possibly even tins of custard. I don't like throwing things like this away, and I think this is going to make me actually use through the things that we have in the house and just to be a bit more aware of what we actually have in the house. I'm not a very good organizer of food, I'm gonna say, because whenever my shopping comes in, I'm not good at rotating it. I can store it okay so that I know what I have, but as far as dates go, yeah, I'm a little clueless on what's actually out in my kitchen. And I do have a few bits outside in our outside storage as well. So, I mean, I know that I've got plenty of cereals in the house. This is 3 meals a day. We all do 3 meals a day. Nobody buys lunch out unless my son does. But that's always comes from his money if that's what he wants to do. But I say I do packed lunches for all of my lot when they go out in the day. So I thought this would be a really good way of using up the things that I have in our house to get a bit more of an idea as to what we have in the house, and obviously to save a little bit of money after Christmas. So each week when I do my grocery haul, what I thought that I would do is I would show you the things that I'd picked up for the £25 allowance that I'm giving myself. I would also show you some of the things that I have in the fridge that definitely need using, because that would always be my first go-to, would be the fridge, because obviously that's what's going to go bad first. Then I will show you some bits in my freezer because I do have still a fair bit of meat. I say it was completely stocked up for Christmas. So I do have things in the house. I say it's not like I'm £25 a week with nothing. I do understand that this challenge would be completely unrealistic and impractical for anybody that hasn't actually got stock in their house already. And I don't want to be insensitive because I do understand that the grocery bills are going up every week that you go in the grocery store. You look at something and you think to yourself, I only paid £1 for that a year ago or 2 years ago. I say the prices are crazy now, and I do understand that. So I just wanted to say that if anybody is actually struggling with their grocery bills and they're watching this, I do like the Too Good To Go app. However, I do feel like it's very hit and miss. And sometimes £3.30 or whatever it is that bag would have cost you, that money can be better spent sometimes on other things, actually knowing what you're going to be picking up. So there is an app that I have never talked about before, and it's not one that I use ever because I don't feel that this is an app that's for me, because I know that I can pay my grocery bills at the end of the week. I feel like this one is a bit more sacred for people that actually really need it. So if you haven't already heard of an app called Olio, this is one that I would definitely recommend that you had a look at. So basically, there are people in your area that are kind of classed as, I think it's food warriors, and they go around and collect donations from retail stores that they would have got rid of, wasted, thrown in the bin, didn't sell as reduced, things like that. But these food warriors, they go and they collect it, they take it back to their own homes. These are all volunteers, and they will take pictures of the food that they receive. They upload the food onto this app, and then you can sign into the app as often as you like and sort of have a look and see if anybody's put anything new on. The times that they upload, I believe, is all a bit hit and miss. It's up to that individual volunteer. So I'm sure that you'll get to know different areas will have different times that things come up. And then basically, once they've put on a picture of the food that they have available, they will say collection up until a certain time in that day. And you do have to put yourself out. You have got to go collect it. Nobody's going to be dropping it around to you. But there is no money involved in this. It is completely free. You go and collect whatever it is that you've asked for. And I say that you have to arrange a mutual time that suits you both for you to go and collect. But this is an absolutely lifesaver for some people. I'm sure of it. I say it is an absolutely brilliant idea. And I think that if you are struggling or know somebody that's struggling to pay for their food each week, tell them about it. Have a look yourself. I say it's an amazing app. I say I don't use it myself. I don't feel like it's a place for me, because there are people that need this. So I understand it's about reducing food waste as well. But I think at the minute, like, there's certain things that your conscience will allow and mine just wouldn't that. So yeah, definitely worth having a look at. This video is not turning all doom and gloom. So I'm going to get back to my grocery haul and I will show you what I picked up this week for my £25. Okay, so this is everything that I picked up sort of as our bare minimum for this week. I say I stuck to my budget and this is what I got. So I picked up some of the wildlife tubes. There is only six in these and I would have possibly been better off going to Aldi to get their 9-pack of Chewbits, because I say nothing was on offer, but I just wanted to go to the one shop and leave it as that. So I went with them. Next, I got the Tesco's garlic and herb soft cheese. I thought this would make some good sort of snacks with some breadsticks for the kids. I got some cheese strings. These are going to be a must in our £25 budget whilst doing this. And so is ham for sort of sandwiches and things. I picked up some single elm lee because this has got a really good date on it and it is perfect for sort of keeping in the fridge if you want to make sort of a pasta meal or anything like that. It's just really good for making sauces to have on hand. I got the 4 pints of semi-skimmed milk. We do already have milk in the fridge that we picked up before New Year, so don't think that this 4 pint is going to last us all week, because that's where most of our budget is probably going to go. I wanted some chicken breast fillets because I say those are kind of an easy go-to. I got some white bread. I actually have 2 loaves already in the freezer because I say if you saw my Aldi Too Good To Go bag, I say I had 2 in there. I got some bread sticks, I say, to go with the soft cheese that I picked up for packed lunches. Broccoli. Onions, I say I just got a multi-pack of these just for going in recipes because I'm sure I'm going to need them. I got some Cathedral City. I did buy the lighter ones before, but my husband has said about how they don't melt very well, sort of if they're having cheese on toast or anything. So I went back to the sort of full fat one. The organic carrots, I didn't order organic. They substituted it and I had gone in store beforehand to return something. And I checked that they didn't have any normal carrots and they didn't. So I say I just went along and I accepted that as a substitution. I got some mushrooms because they're always good for sort of going in and a good ingredient to go into cooking. And then I got our pack of bananas that we pick up. So this is everything that I picked up for this week and it was £25.02. So I feel it's 2 pence over, but I'm still classing that as my £25 spend. Okay, so as promised, I said I was going to put together my meal plan this week. This is not something that I've done on camera before with you, but I've shown you a good amount of food that we have in the house. I say you've seen the salad, the ham, the dips, the bacon. There's things in the house that I obviously need to use up before I start using through the cupboard stuff first. So I have a lot of fresh bits out there that I have in my head
that I know that I want to use. So this is the meal plan that I use. It's just one that I've printed off online. It's the Budget Mum. She does a lot of good free printables that you can use. And yeah, I would definitely say go and have a look at her. But this is the one that I've used. And I say I'm just going to fill this one in with you now and hope that the pen works. So the first one here is a Sunday, but I do my meals of the week videos is the Monday to Sunday. So as I say, you just have to pretend that one's down here. That's fine. But Sundays are normally really easy because we always tend to have a roast. So that one's really simple. Monday is actually New Year's Day and we are going, oh, is it going to work? To my mum and dad's for New Year's Day dinner. So the next thing that I would say that I need to use is I have meat and I had the ham joint that needs using. And I know that I've got eggs in the cupboard and I've got potatoes that are still from Christmas that I got the 2 bags of Maris Pipers at Christmas and I've still got a lot of them left. So I'm actually just going to do a really simple, oh, is it going to work again? So ham, yeah, if you can see my writing, egg and chips, it'll do. So ham, egg and chips, nice and simple. I say that will be absolutely fine. And then I would say I probably need to use my leek before I need to use my salad. So just for ease, I'm probably going to do, because I had the packet of bacon, I do use some of the bacon, I won't use all of it. So bacon and leek. I'll make a pasta dish and that will probably be just sort of a white cheese sauce. So we'll see how that one goes. I'm sure that will be absolutely fine. And now I need to really start thinking about what I can make to use up the salad that I have. And I've also got the dip still from Christmas. I don't know if they'll be any good at this point. But I say we can always taste them and sort of see if they're any good before we put them on anything. But I know that I've got some wraps out there and some chicken in the freezer. So we can do that. And I'm going to put a question mark next to the dips just to remind me that they need to be checked before we actually use them. So the rest of the bacon is going to need using. And I say I'm still probably going to have some salad left over. So on Friday, we might have just simple BLTs. So we have them in rolls. This pen's not working very well. And then just do maybe some chips or wedges maybe for a bit of something different. So then that leaves me one last day, and to be honest, I've got a lot of frozen ready meals that we have, because when we make a meal, if there's a portion of something left over, we'll just put it into sort of an old Chinese takeaway pot and then it will go in the freezer. I don't need to buy ready meals because we make them ourselves. So that one, I kind of class that one. Oh, my pen is definitely not working. So leftovers, and that is my week's meals planned. I think at the minute it's been really easy to do this week with the things that I have. I say it's all fresh in my head. I know that we've got pretty much everything here at the minute. So I think it's going to get a little bit harder the further into this challenge that we go, but I'm definitely up for giving it a go. I say I would like to use up some of the things that we have in our cupboards. Definitely, just to get the actual stock that we have in the house down a little bit, because I'll be honest, it's more than I can manage. And I say I don't want to buy things when they go on offer, not end up using them, and then they go out of date and then they're just no good. There's definitely things that need using through. So this is our meals that are planned. So I say if you wanted to join us on Monday for our meals of the week, and you'll see if I manage to stick to this plan or not. But yeah, I'd love to see you here again soon. Take care, and I'll see you again. Bye.